You know I love music. And every time I get so hot, it makes me want to move. It makes me want to have fun. But it's something about this joint right here. This joint right here. She lost 26 pounds and she was able to get off her metformin that she had been on for years. When you change from the barbecue sauce, let's just say you say, hey Andy, give me some of y'all top favorites. Anybody a sweet baby Ray person?
Yeah.
Anybody a honey mustard person?
Yeah.
What's another name?
Ray.
Any other barbecue sauce? I think sweet baby Ray is number one. Well, let me just take you a walk down to Chick-fil-A. If you go to Chick-fil-A, what kind of dips are we getting?
Polynesia.
I heard Polynesia. Yeah. I heard sweet and sour over here. Any other? What about just a barbecue? No barbecue? Anybody do a honey mustard?
Yeah.
Okay, so if you're getting these foods, I want you all to start looking at the ingredients. Because a lot of the foods have what they call high fructose corn syrup. High fructose corn syrup is the number one ingredient that causes us to have high blood pressure, because high fructose corn syrup is just like molasses going through your artery veins. Yeah, just like that.
On point.
So if you're talking about you at risk for high blood pressure, If you let your blood pressure get so high, and again, it's coming because your blood pressure, I think my patient had, his blood pressure was 189, his bottom number was 201. Your bottom number never supposed to get over 99. But because he never did change his diet, because nobody educated him on how to change his diet, he worked with me for the first 18 days, he was able to get his blood pressure normalized. Even the doctor questioned, what in the world is Angie doing? And everybody who follow me on Facebook, y'all know my slogan. I'm the badass coach in these detox streets. Y'all just remember that. So because I have been studying, but because it happened to me, I went from nursing one day, I was chronically fatigued, I didn't understand what was wrong, my hair was coming out, and when I'm saying hair coming out, I'm not talking about it just being in bald spots. The doctor had to talk in a language that we understand. I've been a nurse over 13 years, so when she said hair coming out, I equated that to be alopecia. But she was talking about that when you comb your hair, how many masses or strands of hair is left in that comb. And if you're doing a lot of hair shedding, that can be led to other chronic health conditions. So when you leave here today, when I'm giving you this checklist to go so you can monitor your health, and it doesn't matter by age or race, because I have seen every walk of life being affected by hair loss, brain fog, and if you don't know what brain fog is, I'm gonna tell you. You got ready to go, and you had your keys in your hand. You go all the way back in the other room, and you say, I forgot something. And you have to go right back to the place you started. Anybody get me like that? Okay, that is called brain fog. And when you are having brain fog, that is a health condition. So when you go to your doctor, I need you to tell them, hey, when I go in the room, I do forget what it is that I normally went into the room to get.